its head out. Okay, gentlemen, listen up, all of you. According to the information so kindly provided to us by the O'Driscolls, the train will be coming north from Big Valley. We're gonna pick it off after it crosses the border into the Grizzlies. There's a raised spot there that should give us good vantage. Charles, you'll keep lookout for any outriders. How's that hand, by the way?
I'll be fine.
Good. I'll take the driver and engineer, then run point. Lenny and Javier, you two take the front cars, deal with any guards. Arthur and Micah, you head straight for the back. That's what we're after. Mr. Cornwall's private car.
You and me, Morgan.
Great.
Have you got a problem with that?
Not if you keep your head for once.
You worry about yourself, huh?
Enough! After Bill blows the tracks, we're gonna need to move fast. Is everyone clear on what they're doing?
Yep. Crystal.
Yes, boss.
Good. Now, come on. Let's ride. Up here after us. Oh, look at you boys. See? This is what I call a crew. Micah Bell, Charles Smith, Arthur Morgan, Javier Escuela, and what about young Lenny here? Always the first man on his horse.
Just happy we're back at him, Dutch.
You sure you're ready for this, kid?
Of course I'm ready.
Just stay calm. Keep your eyes sharp. That goes for all of you. No mistakes. Not again.
So we do this, then we go back to Blackwater to collect.
How many times are you gonna ask the same question, Micah?
That's a lot of damn money to leave sitting for too long.
It would be crazy to go back there now. The place will be swarming with Pinkertons.
We go back when I say we go back, and that's the end of it. Money's safe. You'll just have to trust me. And if the O'Driscolls are right, there'll be a stack of railroad bonds on this train. Good money, once we work out how to cash them. Now everyone, shut up and get your mind on the job at hand. Come on. There's the water tower. Hold up here on the ridge. Is Bill there?
Yeah.
You want to head down, see how he's getting on?
Okay.
Oh!
How you getting on?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You sure?
Of course.
Can I help a little?
All right. Go ahead and set up the detonator by those rocks over there.
Okay, sure.
Now just unspool the wire and then attach it to said detonator. Train will have been and gone if you don't hurry up.
Okay, this is good.
All right. That should do it. You head back up to the others. I got it from here. Train's gonna be here any minute. Head back up there.
Have to say, I'm rather looking forward to it. Just be ready to move quick and remember the plan, all of you, no mistakes.
What's going on?
He says all fine.
We'll soon find out.
Everything okay?
I think so.
Okay, cover your faces. Train should be here any minute now. That includes you, Arthur? Have you forgotten the price of... our heads? Gentlemen, it's time. Good luck, all of you. You all know what to do.
Here we go. Shit! No! What? God!
Oh, you have got to be kidding me!
Where did you find that
moron? Who said it was fine?
It's my fault.
Come on!
You're pathetic. You know that?
Slow this thing down.
Where's Javier?
trail. The others will get him. Come on, we need to stop this train.
Well, I thought you was reading.
All right, we're moving out. Follow me. Gentlemen, listen up, all of you. According to the information so kindly provided to us by the O'Driscolls, the train will be coming north from Big Valley. We're gonna pick it off after it crosses the border into the Grizzlies. There's a raised spot there that should give us good vantage. Charles, you'll keep lookout for any outriders. How's that hand, by the way?
I'll be fine.
Good. I'll take the driver and engineer that run point. Lenny and Javier, you two take the front cars, deal with any guards. Arthur and Micah, you head straight for the back. That's what we're after. Mr. Cornwall's private car.
You and me, Morgan.
Great.
Have you got a problem with that?
Not if you keep your head for once.
You worry about yourself, huh?
Enough! After Bill blows the tracks, we're gonna need to move fast. Is everyone clear on what they're doing?
Yep.
Crystal.
Yes, boss.
Good. Now, come on. Let's ride. Up here after us. Oh, look at you boys. See? This is what I call a crew. Micah Fell, Carl Smith, Arthur Morgan, Javier Escuela, and what about young Lenny here? Always the first man on his horse.
Just happy we're back at him, Dutch.
You sure you're ready for this, kid?
Of course I'm ready.
Just stay calm. Keep your eyes sharp. That goes for all of you. No mistakes. Not again.
So we do this. Then we go back to Blackwater to collect.
How many times you gonna ask the same question, Micah?
That's a lot of damn money to leave sitting for too long.
It would be crazy to go back there now. The place will be swarming with Pinkertons.
We go back when I say we go back, and that's the end of it. The money's safe. You'll just have to trust me. And if the O'Driscolls are right, there'll be a stack of railroad bonds on this train. Good money, once we work out how to cash them. Now everyone, shut up and get your mind on the job at hand. Come on!
Passing you.
Okay!
There's the water tower. Hold up here on the ridge. Whoa! Is Bill there?
Yeah.
You want to head down, see how he's getting on?
Okay.
Damn, espacio.
How you getting on?
Yeah. I'm okay.
You sure?
Of course.
Can I help a little?
All right. Go ahead and set up the detonator by those rocks over there.
Okay, sure.
Now just unspool the wire and then attach it to said detonator.
Okay, this is good.
All right. That should do it. You head back up to the others. I got it from here.
Yeah.
Don't need you distracting me here, Morgan.
No mistakes.
What's going on?
He says all fine.
We'll soon find out.
Everything okay?
I think so.
Okay, cover your faces. Train should be here any minute now. Gentlemen, it's time. Good luck, all of you. You all know what to do.
Here we go. Shit, no!
gotta be kidding me.
Where did you find that moron?
You said it was fine.
My fault.
Come on!
You're pathetic. You know that?
Here we go!
Here we go!
I don't know.
good shooting, kid.
I can see now why the O'Driscolls brought so many boys up here for this.
Arthur, get over here. You two all right?
Yes, let's get the money and go.
We got some fellas holed up in this last car.
Shit.
What are you boys planning on doing in there? Listen to me. We don't want to kill any of you.
Any more of you.
I give you my word, but trust me, we will.
I work for Leviticus Cornwall.
Come on, boys.
We got our orders.
Okay. You asked for it.
We ain't
Five,
opening this door.
Four. Three, two, one. Seems our friends have gone deaf. Wake them up a little!
You got no way in here!
That's enough!
Mr. Williamson, give Mr. Morgan and Mr. Smith some dynamite. You two boys go blow that door open.
Now, don't matter too much to us, but you boys in there might want to take a step back.
Seems good enough. Now light the fuse.
Here we go.
Unless you got a death wish, I'd step back, fellas.
All right, come on. Just walk on out here. We don't want to kill you.
My oh
my. We
just
want to rob your boss. Get on up there. Search that train.
Look at this place. It's like a palace.
Well, now I've seen everything.
Oh, you two got the safe? I'll search the rest.
Oh, yes. Should be easy as cake. You're just gonna stand there, kid. Pour me some brandy, will ya? I'm parched.
Shut up. Me and Arthur did all the work.
Yeah, kid did good.
Didn't see you rushing to jump on that train.
He's keen. I'll give you that. Okay, let's see if we can get this open.
When you work for a
come on,
of a bitch.
Come on, get in there. Ha. Ah. There, see, that's how it's done. Shit, just a pile of papers.
Bonds?
I don't think so. Here, make yourself useful. At least we all know you can read.
Give me those.
Railroad contracts, invoices, blah, blah, blah. You got anything?
Not really. Sugar imports from the Spanish West Indies. A lot of sugar. Some fancy new boaties ordered from Europe.
I am not robbing another boat as long as I live. Have you checked all the drawers and cabinets?
Let's hurry this along, boys.
Now, this looks like something.
These just seem to be contracts. Arthur, have you looked down the end there?
I think I got him.
Nice.
Thank God. Come on.
What did you find?
These bonds. They worth anything?
Oh, sure. Bearer bonds. I think we can probably sell these pretty easily.
Well done. Now, would you get rid of all of this?
The train?
Yeah, get it out of here.
What about them?
What do you think?
I don't know.
It's up to you. Kill them, leave them here, take them with you on the train. Just make sure they don't send no folk after us.
Okay.
See you back at camp. When you get back, we'll be moving on. The rest of you, let's ride!
Okay. Get on the train. Quick. All of you. Any bright ideas, I kill all three. So behave. Come on. Move.
We won't tell a soul, I swear.
If I hear so much as a footstep from this car, you'll end up like all your friends out here. Get a move on.
Lord's sake, put that book away and go help. Oh, Mary Beth.
So, we getting out of this hellhole?
We're gonna try. Weather seems stable.
And we just robbed the Leviticus Cornwall train.
We got money in our pockets. The worst is behind us, gentlemen. So the question is, where now?
I know this country a little. I told you, we should set up camp in Horseshoe Overlook near Valentine. We'll be able to hide out there no problem, as long as we keep our noses clean.
Well, then let's go. Clean noses and everything else. Arthur, you're in that one. Bring Hosea. I know you two like to talk about the good old days and what's gone wrong with old Dutch.
Get over here!
Yes, boss.
You two ride up ahead. Make sure there's no surprises. We've had enough of those.
Me? With the boy?
Just go.
Come on, kid. You can buy me a whiskey.
Take a look.
You all right back there?
Does everything look all right?
Well, what's going on?
Ah, I broke the goddamn wheel.
All right.
Let's get it fixed.
You need help?
I reckon we can handle it. All right, Charles, you and me hold the thing up while you try and put the wheel back on, Arthur.
You still strong enough to hold up a wagon?
Shut up.
I'm just saying.
Don't say less. Pick the wheel up. Nearly there. There.
See? You ain't so useless after all.
Not quite.
What do you think?
If they wanted trouble, we wouldn't have seen them.
Poor bastards. We really screwed them over down here. Come on, let's not push our luck.
What happened?
Well, get in. I'll tell you. Can we just get there?
Now.
Stay on this trail. We'll follow the river, then cut left, inland. So?
Yes.
The Indians in these parts got sold a very raw deal. This is the heartlands we're going to. Good farming and grazing country. They lost it all.
Stole them clean away from them, it was, every blade of grass. Killed or herded up to the reservations in the middle of nowhere.
And how's that different from anywhere else?
Well, maybe it's not. I just heard some of the army out here was particularly, unpleasant about it.
Unpleasant? How do you rob and kill people pleasantly? We don't, in spite of Dutch's talk.
I fear I was perhaps trying to simplify something more complicated for the benefit of our blockheaded driver here.
Hey, don't blame it on me. Never forget, this here's a con man, Charles, born and bred. Just because it sounds fancy don't mean he knows a damn thing about what he's talking about. So, what happened to your tribe?
I don't even know if I have one. At least, not that I can remember. My father was a colored man. He told me he lived with our people for a while. A number of free men did, but when we were forced to move from our lands, the three of us fled. I was too young to really remember much. All life I've been on the run. A couple years later, some soldiers captured my mother. Took her somewhere. We never saw her again. We drifted around. He was a very sad man, and the drink had a mean hold on him. Around 13, I just took off on my own.
That was about the age we found young Arthur here. Maybe a little older. A wilder delinquent you never did see. But he learned fast.
Not as fast as Marston, apparently.
Wait, I don't understand. What's the problem between you two?
Arthur?
It's a long story. We still heading the right way?
That depends. Are we still heading west in search of fortune and repose in virgin forests as we plan? No. Are we heading in the correct direction on our desperate escape from the law, eastwards down the mountains? Yes, I believe so.
You know this area?
A little. I've been through a couple of times. There's a livestock town not too far from here called Valentine. Cowboys, outlaws, working girls. Our kind of place.
Driscolls?
Probably them too.
Pinkertons?
Let's hope not.
And this place we're going. Wait. What's it called again?
Horseshoe Overlook.
It's a place to lie low?
It'll do for now. And how low do you think Dutch is really going to lie? It's just, you know, maybe it's me who's changed, not him. But we kept telling him that ferry job didn't feel right. You and me had a real lead in Blackwater that could have worked out.
Maybe.
It just isn't like Dutch to lose his head like that.
Things go wrong sometimes. People die. It's the way it is. Always has been. Me, you, Dutch. We've all been in this line of work a long time. And we're still here, so I figure we must have got it right a hell of a lot more than we got it wrong. What are you working on there, anyway?
Just some yarrow and ginseng. Good for the health. Better than that stuff you buy in the store. Yeah, you can have all this. I'm at the point where I can do it with my eyes closed.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Yeah.
Head in there. Follow the track for a bit.
Thanks.
Hey, slow up. I'll jump on.
Easy now.
Okay, let's go.
Any trouble getting in here, Javier?
Nope. It went well. This is a good spot.
Excellent. I think this will work for us, Arthur. For now, anyway. Here we are, gentlemen. Home sweet home.
You weren't wrong, Hosea. This place is perfect.
I hope so.
Gentlemen, we have survived.
For now.
Now it is time to prosper.
Arthur and I were about to prosper in Blackwater. We were onto something big. Then Micah got you all excited about that ferry, and here we are.
We have all made mistakes over the years, Hosea. Every last one of us. But I kept us together. Kept us alive. Kept the nooses off our neck.
I guess I'm just worried. I ain't got that long, Dutch. I want folks safe before I go.
Me too.
And now we are stuck. East of the Grizzlies and out of money. And a long way from our dream of virgin land in the west.
I know, my brother. But we are safe. We make a bit of money here. Then we move again. Head out around them. Be west of Uncle Sam. In a few months, buy some land.
I hope so.
Would you just look around you? This world has its consolations.
Gentlemen. I'm going to head into the local town and, see if I can strike up a little business.
Of course, Herr Strauss. I prefer robbing banks to usury. Seems more dignified somehow. Now, everyone, put your tools down for a moment. Come on, gather around. Quickly now. I know that things have been tough, but we are safe now, and we are far too poor. So it is time for everyone to get to work.
Get to work, but stay out of trouble. Remember, we are itinerant workers.
Laid off when they shut down our factory to the north. Now get out there and see what you can find. Uncle, Reverend Swanson, no more passengers. It is time for everyone to earn their keep.
There is a town a little way down the track named Valentine. Livestock town, all mud and morons, if I remember right. That seems a decent place to start.
And, we need food. Real food. That means every day. One of you.
And remember, whatever it is that you find, the camp gets its slice. Now be sensible out there.
Now the girls have your tent ready, Mr. Morgan. Come with me. You two will be ready shortly. We put you over here.
I'm sure everything will be fine, Miss Grimshaw.
It should be. Most of your stuff from Blackwater got saved.
Everything apart from my money.
Oh, don't remind me.
Well, we can always make more money.
We're gonna have to. Miss Jackson, I've seen shit with more common sense than you. Do it properly.
off the mountain and rode east into some pretty enough country called the Heartlands. Ain't been this far east in many a year. Dutch seems a little better. His eyes are sparkling once more, and I can see he's thinking a little clearer. I think we all feel a little happier, in spite of Blackwater and that whole mess.
Arthur?
Jose?
Quite a day.
Let's hope so.
There's a bunch of the boys already in Valentine. Bill, Charles, and Javier. And Swanson found something down at the train station by the lake, apparently. And Strauss came back with that creepy little smile on his face. I'm sure there's a whole list of unfortunates he's forced money upon.
Thank you. And you?
I'm gonna read a book.
My dear boy.
What's going on?
Nothing. Nothing at all. For the first time in weeks, nothing. We're free. We're free to plan our own futures once more.
I hope so, Dutch.
You kept the faith, Arthur. You always kept it.
And I ain't losing it now.
Hi. Good morning.
What's wrong? Thought you'd be happy to be off that mountain.
Oh, I don't know.
You ain't been yourself for a while.
I don't know. I don't want to talk about it.
How is that food coming along, Mr. Pearson?
Not long now.
Morning, Arthur.
Arthur, don't forget, I'm more than happy to craft you something if you bring me the right materials. Just remember, my items are one of a kind, Mr. Morgan. I'll need some more materials before I can make something like that.
I reckon I need to get my hands on some material.
You could really use some more meat, Mr. Morgan.
Sorry, got nothing for you right now.
Getting real low on meat here.
Don't you overcook this now, Pearson.
Thank you, Arthur.
Good day, Mr. Morgan.
Glad to be off that mountain, Mr. Pearson?
Yes, indeed. Lots to do now.
Yeah, for all of us. My name ain't no concern of yours.
I'm hungry.
I don't give a damn.
Look, you seem like a decent fella behind it all.
Then you ain't a good judge of character.
Yeah, well, we'll leave it there then. Forget about me. I'm starving. Why are you so close to me?
Smells delightful, Mr. Pearson.
Give me a chance.
Morning. Ha ha.
corner.
Anybody spare me a bite?
Hi there.
Cruel bastards. Tying me up right by the poop.
I'm famished, Mr. Pearson.
All in good time.
That smells so good. Please don't hurt me.
Mr. Morgan, bring me some materials, and I'll be glad to make something nice for you.
I reckon I'm gonna think about it.
Thank you.
an outlaw.
Yes, if they only knew how boring it really is. Morning, Arthur.
Is our food gonna be ready soon?
I hope you're charging Javier all that attention he's been getting.
Don't start with this now.
Arthur.
Hi there.
Good boy. That's it, boy. Careful not to work yourself to death there, Uncle.
I was thinking.
Yeah, does it pay well?
Eventually.
So, while the rest of us are busy stealing, killing, lying, fighting to try to survive, you get to think all day.
Well, it's a strange world we live in, Arthur Morgan.
Hey, you want to head into town? See if we can find anything out?
Sure. I got some errands to run.
Great. Go check the horses are ready.
You gonna take the old man into town? You take us too?
Well, what you got planned?
Nothing. We'll find something for y'all two to do. We always do.
We're bored out of our minds. Been cooped up here for 2 weeks now. Karen's about ready to murder Grimshaw.
Well, can Miss Grimshaw spare you?
Can Miss Grimshaw spare you? What's happened to you, Arthur? 3 young, healthy women want you to take them a robbing. You're worried about house chores. Let's go.
Fair enough. You got me. Come on in.
I can't believe we're going to see civilization. Feels like weeks since we did.
Yeah, Valentine.
Very embodiment of civilization.
You ladies are going to love it.
Okay, then. Let's go.
All right. Out through the trees here, then take a left.
Sing us a song.
All right. I got a girl in Fairyville. Can't be screwed because she's too damn ill. So I don't go down there no more. There's a blue horse laying outside her door. I had a girl in Valentine. Likes to drink that fancy wine. Blue and her hat was 2 feet tall. Cracking her best paid for it all. I got a girl in Fairyville.
Go right here. It's quicker.
Can't get here because she won't stay still. And screams and barks and hollers. Won't take less than $7. I got a girl in Fairyville.
I messed it up.
I got a girl across the lake. Hair down there like a horse's mane. I got a girl and she's got a thing. Fits my feet like a diamond ring.
Is one of you gonna get that fella's horse?
Well, I got lumbago. It's very serious.
I thought you wanted to head into town.
Yes, but this won't take long. Look at the poor fella.
Go on. He's an old man.
Come on. One of you.
Lumbago, really? You all right there, friend?
Oh, hey, you couldn't help me get my other horse back from over there, could you? I'd really appreciate the help. I'm worried this one here will bolt on me, too, if I leave him.
Sure, no problem.
Thanks. It's the white one over there.
Okay. Whoa, now. Good girl.
This way. Come on. Here you go.
You're a gentleman, sir. A gentleman.
No, not really. I was just trying to impress the women.
Well, anyway, thank you.
I mean, can you do another old fella a favor? Get back on the damn wagon.
To Valentine!
Woo!
You're turning into a regular old fairy godmother there, Arthur.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means you got a heart. A small one, perhaps, hidden deep inside, but a real one. And you have it, your pulse of old lizard.
Lizards have hearts.
Well, Arthur, I'm proud of you.
To be honest, if you lot hadn't been here, I probably would have robbed him.
Well, you did.
Very funny.
This looks like a decent little town.
Other people, finally.
Look at all that snow on the mountains.
Sure don't want to be back up there.
You think we should have asked Molly to come with us?
Oh, no. Miss O'Shea is far too high and mighty now for the likes of us, or to do any real work. She's a society lady now. Okay. Take a good look around, ladies. Let's see what we got here.
Go left here, down the main street.
Sheriff's always on the right. Sure you can pick up some bounties there, Arthur.
Heaven forbid you put your head on the line.
Yeah, well, that's a young man's game.
Ooh, yes. We can get up to some mischief here, all right.
Just remember, keep a low profile.
Will you remember that, though, Arthur?
Probably not.
Let's park up down the end there, near the stables.
You got a problem?
Alright, here we are, just like I said, the cultural center of civilization. Man at his finest.
Uncle, what are we doing?
Well, we're gonna do what any self-respecting maniac does. Put the women to work.
With pleasure. We'll start at the saloon.
Okay, just stay out of trouble and don't get yourselves noticed.
Right, I need to get something from the stores.
Okay, well, we'll see you at the general store when you're done.
Come on, ladies. Imagine we're in Paris.
Come on.
So that's how you see yourself, is it? A maniac?
Well, in my youth, I used to be known as the one-shot kid.
Okay. I'm not gonna ask why.
You are a sad man, Arthur Morgan. But I know you love me.
Desperately. You're my favorite parasite. No. Ringworm's my favorite parasite. You're my second favorite parasite.
Very funny.
I lied. Ringworm, then rats with the plague, then you.
Shut up. This is the place now. Come on. Afternoon.
So, what do you need?
Hell, a drop of whiskey for a start. Well, something to pass the time while we're waiting on the women.
Always thinking ahead, ain't you?
You're looking a bit tired there, Arthur.
Why don't you pick up some coffee while we're here?
Let me know if you have any questions, fellers. Whiskey's on the top shelf, nearest the door.
You not getting anything, Arthur?
I don't know. Maybe. So, you're actually buying for once? Are you feeling all right?
See this? Young folk got no respect for their elders no more. What do you reckon? A lamb or a sausage?
Well, this here's a sheep town. The lamb's the best in the state.
Now I know what the smell is.
Well, that's a ripe cheese, all right.
But look at this. A jaw harp.
What is this list of yours?
I got a lot to replenish after that god-awful time in the mountains.
All done.
Thank you kindly. This should do the trick.
Yep, that's fine whiskey.
That should do us. Let's go wait for them outside.
Here's to your good health, sir. And to being down here off that mountain.
Absolutely.
It's a funny world, you know. This time in my career, I pictured myself being married to an heiress.
Gentlemen, I think I got something good.
What? What?
I snuck into this fancy house. Acted like a servant girl. Usually works. Someone was saying her sister was taking a trip from New York or someplace. Train full of rich tourists heading to Saint Denis and then cruising off to Brazil.
Okay.
A train laden with baggage and passing through a bit of deserted country at night as to get to the docks in time for the tides in some place called Scarlet Meadows.
Yeah, I know it. Yeah, it's right out in there, New Hanover. Right, it's real quiet out there.
Sounds good. Where's Tilly and Karen?
I think at the hotel. They were picking up some drunken fellas that they was gonna rob.
Why?
It seemed easy. They have been gone for quite a while.
I guess I'll go see if there's any trouble.
Oh, there's Tilly over there. That does not look ideal.
Excuse me.
Get your hands off me!
You thought I wouldn't find you, Tilly?
You can go kiss a damn snake for all I care. Get off me! Get off of me!
I've been looking too long. I got you now. Get your hands off her. Who are you?
A friend of mine.
Get the hell off of her, you son of a bitch.
Hey, take it easy. There's no problem here.
There will be if you don't get out of here right now.
You're making a big mistake, Tilly Jackson.
Just get lost.
I ain't doing this with you right now.
Go wait with Uncle and Mary Beth. They're across the street.
Okay. Thanks, Arthur.
Uncle! Look after her. I'm gonna go see about Karen in the hotel.
Can I help you, sir?
Try and help people!
can manage. Are you doing all you can?
Sir?
Can I help you, sir?
No. Wrong room.
No harm done. Join me. I'm a Chelonian. Have you read our book?
No, I was just leaving.
Please don't bother the other guests, sir. A bath, perhaps? No trouble now, please. Well, get the hell out of here, will you?
Sorry. Wrong room.
Get out of here, buddy. I paid.
Ain't paid a hitter, you goddamn animal. Come here! Next time, avoid me. What the hell are you doing here?
Trying to play him. Not very well.
You okay?
Fine.
You sure?
Yeah. Nothing to worry about. Just men, but stupid bastard was boasting about the bank.
The bank?
Sure, I know small town banks are usually a waste of time, but this is a livestock town. There's lots of cash sometimes.
Okay. Keep investigating.
I will.
I hope everything's okay up there.
After you. Thank you, Arthur. I don't much like being saved, but when I have to be.
I understand.
You okay?
Sure. He only punched me. Arthur punched him a lot harder.
All right, now.
Hey, who's that guy over there looking at us?
Weren't you in Blackwater a few weeks back?
Me? No, sir. Ain't from there.
Oh, you were. Well, I definitely saw you with a bunch of fellers.
Me? No. Impossible. Listen, buddy. Come here for a minute.
I saw you.
Come here.
Come on, get.
I don't like this. Me neither. Go get the girls home. I'm gonna go have a word with our friend.
Be careful, Arthur.
Just a word. Yeah.
For the love of God.
Just stay away, okay?
Just borrowing it.
You stay away from me!
Get back here, right now! Why are you telling lies about me?
No. I got it wrong, partner. I got it very wrong. Now, please help me up.
I ain't never been in Blackwater.
Then why are you chasing me?
I've got an unfortunate face.
Yes, me too. Now, please, pull me up. Please. I'm begging you.
All right. Come on. You okay, partner?
No. No, I am not. I'm a mess.
Well, you ain't dead.
There is that. Jimmy Brooks.
I think it's best for both of us if we pretend this never happened.
Well, I agree. You saved my life. You're a good man, and I, here. You want a pen? It's one of them steel ones.
Oh. That's very kind of you. But I'm not a good man, Jimmy Brooks. Not usually. You see, I was in Blackwater. I kill people. And maybe I should have killed you. Should I have killed you? Jimmy Brooks.
Me? I never saw you. Not now, not never. I think we have an understanding.
Of course we do. Jimmy Brooks. I will remember that. I've got a good memory.
I haven't.
Welcome to the stream.
Not one lick. Not one cent.
Hello.
In this year old mind.
What's up?
Come on. You have a nice day now, sir.
Time to head back to this.
Here is a sub for playing Red Dead.
Hold on. Let me see this. YouTube. Oh, so you subscribing?
Yeah, why not?
Hey! My horse!
Oh, that's fine. That's cool.
Have you been round to Lake Isabella?
No, I haven't been to Lake Isabella. To just hitch my horse, see what else there is to do around the town.
It's nice cause the best base stat horse is there, and on the way there is two legendary animals.
Should I go there right now?
If you want. There is a bison and wolf.
So I need to find the lake.
What chapter are you on?
I'm on chapter 2.
Alright, so I need to find the lake.
What chapter are you on?
I'm on chapter 2. Alright, so I need to find the lake.
Where is the lake? God damn it, I haven't been nowhere on this map.
West side, pretty far north.
Alright, so if I just keep going to the west and north, I'll find it.
Alright, so if I just keep going to the
west. Oh, I found it. Lake Isabella.
Nice. That's it.
Where's that sound?
It's the YouTube.
Nice. That's it.
Where's that sound?
What the hell?
Yep.
On the west side of the lake is the horse, and the east is the bison and wolf's mile.
Alright, I'm on my way to the lake.
Make sure you have ammo. The bison takes 7 rifle bullets.
Alright. Damn. Where's my rifle? They take your guns? From the beginning of the story mode, I had like rifles and all that.
Get off your horse and check.
This isn't my first horse. Should I go back to the camp and get my real horse?
This isn't my first horse.
That's
Should I go back to the camp and get my real horse? This isn't my first horse.
Yeah. Is it the same saddle?
I don't think so.
Yep.
You think I can kill him with a pistol?
Maybe. If you headshot. Good luck, my man.
All right, thank you. I'm gonna keep going.
Have you done the mission with Hosea that you get the animal map?
I don't think so. Oh, is that it?
Then the bison and wolf won't show up, I don't think, but the horse will.
Is this what you're talking about? With all the animals?
Now go into your satchel and look for maps.
Let's go, girl.
When you are off the horse, hold left DPA.
Hold left DPA. Hold left DPA.
Open your satchel.
Open your satchel.
Am I supposed to read this journal?
No.
Oh, it's the right on the D-pad, not left.
No.
Oh, it's the right on the D-pad, not left.
Sleeo first.
No. Oh, it's the right on the
Sorry, D-pad. My bad.
All right, so I should take a nap first.
Yeah, then check for the map, cause if you can, the bison only shows up at daytime.
Bye.
Hold on, girl. That's my luck.
God damn it. Come on, girl. Yep. Long time, boy.
Here. Maybe this is our man.
You a bounty hunter, mister?
Maybe. It depends. But I'm guessing you ain't here to pass the day, turn yourself in, or discuss the finer points of county law.
Then I don't need to know much more than that, till I got a reason to.
All right.
You smell that?
This here's a livestock town, mister. Attracts delinquents and reprobates like flies.
Now, I'm not a fellow to pass a quick judgment, but I've been around long enough to know you don't hire a saint to catch a sinner. You bring me what I need, and I'll pay you well, and I won't ask no questions.
So, what is it you need?
Why don't you have a look at that poster on the wall over there?
He's a low-down huckster. He's been poisoning folks with his miracle cure from here to Annsburg. Killed more than Landon Ricketts without even pulling a trigger. Gets some kind of sick satisfaction out of it.
Feller over at the saloon says he thought he saw him by the gorge straight north of here.
You think you can bring him in? The money's good.
I need him alive, though. I want to make sure the women he witted get compensated before he swings.
I'll see what I can do.
Well, good luck to you.
And we need him alive. That's an important point.
Alive, I got it.